I do not own the rights to this music. Hello, and welcome to Sunday School Summary with Brother Ron. Sunday School lesson for Sunday, November the 19th, 2023. Our reference material for the Sunday School Summary is based upon the International Sunday School Lesson Series as published by the Sunday School Publishing Board. We are discussing God's Law is Love as the title of the Fall Lesson Series, and it discusses the role of God's law as it relates to our faith in Jesus Christ. The God's Law is Love Lesson Series is categorized into three units or groups of lessons, and we are in Unit 3, and we are discussing Christ Frees Where the Law Enslaves. And it discusses the teachings of Jesus versus the Mosaic Law as it applies to Jewish and Gentile Christians. The title of our third lesson in the Unit 3 Fall 2023 Lesson Series is titled Live As You Were Taught. And that is that salvation comes through the saving grace and faith in Jesus Christ, as Paul teaches. The key verse comes from Colossians chapter 2, verses 6 through 7a, and it reads, "So then, just as you received Christ Jesus as Lord, continue to live your lives in Him, rooted and built up in Him, strengthened in the faith." The title, Live As You Are Taught, is from the book of Colossians, or Paul's letter to the Colossians. Now, Colossae was a city in the Roman province of Asia Minor, a part of modern-day Turkey. The Apostle Paul did not start this church and had not visited when he wrote this epistle. The Apostle Paul composed the epistle to the church at Colossae in response to a visit from an early Christian named Epaphras. And Epaphras appears to have been converted during one of Paul's missionary journeys when Paul preached in the nearby city of Ephesus for 2 years, and he is acknowledged as one of the founders of the church at Colossae. Now, Epaphras informed Paul that the Colossian church was wavering in their faith and were subject to deception about the faith concerning Jewish legalism and pagan mysticism incorporated from pagan gods. Now, Paul wrote his epistle to refute each of the theological errors the Colossians were tempted to embrace, which brings us to today's lesson. There are three summary lesson points for today. Freed from legalism, and that's from Colossians chapter 2, verses 16 and 17. Freed from mysticism from Colossians chapter 2, verses 18 and 19, and freed from asceticism from Colossians chapter 2, verses 20 through 23. The passages for the lesson today revolve around the words faith, legalism, asceticism, and mysticism. Now, we know that faith is the complete trust, assurance, belief, or confidence in God. And Paul instructs the Colossians that spiritual growth is through faith in Jesus Christ in today's lesson. Legalism is the strict adherence of focus of Mosaic law, good works, or church rules as evidence of salvation or righteousness with God. In today's lesson, Paul reminds the Colossians that salvation comes through faith in Jesus Christ alone. Now, asceticism is to voluntarily abstain from physical concerns, primarily those closely associated with the satisfaction of the human needs, such as food, drink, sexual relations, sleep, and material possessions, and is designed to be more spiritual or to gain a deeper understanding of spiritualism. In today's lesson, Paul reminds the Colossians that asceticism cannot save us from our sins, only faith through our faith in Jesus Christ. Mysticism is the sense of some form of contact with the divine and is often understood in the Christian tradition as involving union with God. And Paul reminds the Colossians that spiritual growth and unity with God is through Jesus Christ in today's lesson. Freed from legalism from Colossians chapter 2, verses 16 through 17. In these passages, Paul reminds the Colossians of the gospel he preached, that the right Christian relationship with God is based on faith in Jesus Christ alone and not by observing festivals or abstaining from certain foods. He goes on to say that, therefore, do not let anyone judge you by what you eat or drink or with regard to religious festivals. He said, these are only a shadow of the things that were to come, and the reality is found in Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ freed Christians from the legalisms of the Mosaic Law. Freed from mysticism, and that's from Colossians chapter 2, verses 18 through 19. And these passages, Paul tells them not to fall for the mysticism. He says, do not let anyone who delights in false humility and the worship of angels disqualify you. And he says that such a person that goes into detail about what they have seen, they are puffed up with idle notions about their unspiritual mind, meaning that it is on worldly things and not on godly things through our faith in Jesus Christ. He says that these people have lost all connections with the head, from whom the whole body, supported and held together by its ligaments and sinews, grows as God causes it to grow. So he's saying that they have lost connection with Jesus Christ, and that is the head of the church. And he says the whole body is supported and held together by our faith in Jesus Christ. Our third and final summary point is freed from asceticism, and that's from Colossians chapter 2, verses 20 through 23. And in these passages, Paul reminds the Colossians that they have died with Christ and they have died to the elemental spiritual forces of the world. And he goes on to say, why would they want to go back to that? Because they have died with Jesus Christ, and they do not belong to the world, but they belong to Jesus Christ. He goes on to say that do not allow people to tell you, do not touch, do not handle, or do not taste things. And he says these are rules which have to do with things that are all destined to perish, and they are based on human commands and not worldly and not godly. He goes on to say that the regulations have the appearance of wisdom with their self-imposed worship, false humility, and harsh treatment of the body, but they lack any value in restraining these sensual indulgences. In other words, they cannot save themselves by their abstination or abstaining from worldly things. They have to be saved through their faith in Jesus Christ. So this is Brother Ron with the Sunday School Summary for Sunday, November the 19th, 2023. Thank you for watching. Have a blessed week, and we hope to see you next Sunday for another edition of Sunday School Summary with Brother Ron.